Welcome to the glass plate. We're going to do a real-life example. The system we are going to consider is ourselves. Suppose you got sick and you needed antibiotics. You take your medicine. For the doctor, it's crucial to understand how long it takes before that medicine is out of your body and you need a second intake. With our knowledge of mass balances, stirred tanks, and a little bit of searching on the internet, we can come up with a model that describes this and shows you how transport phenomena inside your body on a coarse scale works, but it's nice to see. Actually, what is happening, this is us, well, part of blood, and here is one of the two kidneys, and I'll only draw one. Basically, for the use of what we do, seeing how medicine stays in your body and is removed by the kidneys, we can see ourselves, at least our blood, as a stirred tank that has some 5 liters for an adult male of blood. That blood obviously circulates, but that circulation is in here, except for a part that goes through the kidneys. So there is blood going through the kidneys and back into that total system, of course. And the kidneys take some out. When this has original concentration C, it's a stirred tank reactor, so here's concentration C, the kidneys will remove. They have, if you look at the bloodstreams, about 20% of our blood running through both the kidneys, 10% through each. But they cannot clean everything in that single pass. They do only a fraction. And we can think of that a much smaller amount of blood is flowing through the kidneys as cleaned. Everything that is also through them and is not cleaned, we could bypass and then put it in here, and it doesn't do anything. So the very basic system that we have is here, where the kidneys make sure that from this small blood flow, everything is removed. That is obviously saying as saying there's a larger blood flow and only a part is removed. And the size of this blood flow from which everything is removed is depending on the medicine. And it is in the case that we are going to discuss about 0.5 milliliter per second. And what we have, these numbers come from an antibiotics. And that is called gentamicin. It's a standard antibiotic. And thus we need to know if initially you have, let me do it in blue, initially you have by the intake a concentration C naught, so at T equals zero, your blood contains C naught of this medicine, your kidneys are going to take part out. We don't need to consider that. All we need to know is that that flow returning has no medicine anymore. And the question is, at what time do we have C naught over 2 left? The half-life, so to say, of this medicine. Okay, how do we do that? Oh, by now, looking at the drawing, I can almost forget that this is about kidneys. This is a mass balance that I need to set up for that medicine. And a mass balance will read the ddt of the mass in your blood of that medicine, V times C, equals what comes in. That is a flow with zero concentration, minus what goes out, that is the flow with the concentration in your blood, because it's treated as a CSTR, that is roughly what we are when you consider these systems, plus a zero because we don't produce any of these medicine. And the question is, can we solve this? Well, yes, we can. This is actually one that we did before. It's not so complicated once you've seen the trick. Do separation of variables and realize that V, the amount of blood, is virtually a constant. dt. Okay, logarithm of c equals minus Vy over Vt plus some integration constant capital C. Integration constant can be found if you have an initial condition, which we have. Put it in, at t equals 0, there's a c naught here, so this one equals the logarithm of c naught. And thus we can write a solution, logarithm c over c naught equals minus Vy V times time. And you see that the concentration decreases, that's what our kidneys do. And you see that I can easily answer now the question. If the concentration, only half is left, then the logarithm of half, that is this side, C is C naught over 2, and that C naught drops out, equals minus 5V over the time that we're looking for, T half if you want, a subscript half, not multiplication. And thus, T half, the half-life, half-time of this medicine in your body is V over the flow, effective flow through your kidneys, like logarithm of 2. And if I put in the numbers, that is 1.9 hour. So after about 2 hours, half of the medicine that you took in is gone. After another 2 hours, a quarter is gone, and so on. Depending on what the level in your body should be, pharmacists and doctors make a prescription for you to keep the medicine between a certain bound within your body and cure you. Bottom line, transport phenomena is active everywhere. Try these examples for yourself and think about transport phenomena in your body. You're full with it. See you next time.